Hello everyone, this is HPI Guys Model Workshop, and today I want to show you a type of kit that is my most favorite of all kits. Everybody knows that's been watching the different reviews that I like to build just about anything and everything, but my most favorite type of kit to build is a wooden ship, specifically a square rigger ship, back from the olden days, back in the 1600s, 1700s, 1800s, when square-rigged sailing ships owned the seas, naval battles were fought between countries, the Spanish, the English, the Americans all ruled the ocean with their square riggers, and they had pretty amazing battles. Books and songs and romance stories have all been written about them. We've all seen the movies and the ships, and I like building them because I like working with wood, and I've always liked building things like this. This is the most recent kit I've picked up. This is from a company called Model Expo, and I've never ordered from them before. And this past weekend, I received an email from them that they are running a 40% off sale on their website, and they had a lot of different kits that were available for that 40% off. So I thought I'd give them a try. Well, what I picked up was this Guns of History by Model Shipways Naval Smoothbore 18th century model ship cannon. And this is supposed to be in 1/16th scale, so it comes out to a nice size. A lot of the other ships I've built, you know, the cannon detail on them is less than an inch long because these were massive ships. And this kit ends up being a very nice size. You can see right on the box there that it's 8 1/4 inches wide, 5 1/4 inches deep, 3 inches tall. And it kind of argues with itself there. It says scale 1/24th and scale 1/16th. I think it's 1/16th scale after I looked at it and measured the cannon and held it in my hands. I don't think it's 1/24th because we've all built 1/24th cars, and when I start showing you the parts, the figures that go with a 1/24th scale car would not fit into this very well. So we could take a look here at some of the parts in the box. Like I said, I did pick this up from modelexpo.com, and it did cost me on sale only $24, and I did have to pay full price for shipping though, which was $9, so the whole entire kit cost me about $32. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be in a kit like this when you get it. First thing you'll get, and you're going to notice, is a parts manual. And this is pretty common in plastic kits, but not as common as it used to be. Now, in a kit like this, these are very, very important to go through. And you can see after I bought the kit, after it arrived, all those pencil marks. And you really need to take this kit out of the box, and you need to set everything out, and you need to count and make sure that you have all the stuff that you're supposed to. And the reason you want to do that is because you need to get a hold of these companies right away. Companies like Ravel, AMT, anybody by Round 2, if you're missing a part, you can get something really quick. And, you know, you send in a request, and they don't ask a lot of questions. These companies, they spend a lot of time making sure everything in the kit is perfect. So in my past experience, I don't know how Model Expo is, but my past experience with, like, Latina model ships and all that, they aren't too swift on replacing parts that you say are missing. They figure you just screwed it up and now you want a free part. So it is very important to pick, you know, double check this list, and it's a couple pages long, you can see, and you got to really check those to make sure that you're getting everything in there. The wood, the white and brass castings, the white metal, and the different types of wire, cable, string, everything that's included, you really need to make sure that's all in there. Instructions on these model ships, they don't really tell you a lot, depending on the company you buy it from. Now, this looks very, you know, if you bought a plastic model and it was one page like this, and that was pretty much your directions, you'd be saying, what the hell? On a kit like this, that's very expected. These are detailed more for a craftsman. Now, this kit here could be built by a complete novice. You would just have to take your time, keep referring to the pictures, and referring to the main way that they tell you how to build everything, which is written directions. And you just have to go through it all and read through it. Now, I recommend sitting down, looking at the pictures, and reading through it a couple times before you ever start working on the kit. And the reason you want to do that is because if you screw up, you either have to find a way to replace it. Now, if you screw up some of these white metal parts, you're pretty much done. unless you can cast a new part. What you can do is maybe go buy some Alumilite at Hobby Lobby at a discount and put the part back together with some epoxy and recast it in resin and then paint it. But you'd rather not have to do that. The wood, what's nice about all the wood that's used in these kits is most hobby stores like Hobby Lobby, Michael's, and any neighborhood hobby store will carry basswood and plywood strips for you. So you can just go in with the broken part or the wood that you cut off too much of, that you use too much of in the kit, and you can find a replacement for it quite easily. But the cast stuff, you're going to have to do yourself if you screw it up. You can't call them for another part because a lot of times they don't make the parts available outside of an entirely new kit. And if they do, they're going to charge you almost as much as a kit would be anyways. So make sure you go through those quite well. But I do think if you've built a car model before, you could do a pretty darn good job of building a wood ship model. Now, everything that's in the box, we'll just lay it out here and then we'll go through it all. This is everything that's inside the big blue box. That's it. Doesn't look like a whole lot of stuff, but we're going to start taking it apart and you're going to see. The first big part you see is this right here, and it's been scribed by a laser, and it's been cut out, so it will pop out of that sheet real easy. And you can see it's got the dark edges on there because they do use lasers for these now. They used to use a die cutter, and nowadays they use lasers because it makes a much cleaner cut. And this part is going to end up being the wall of the ship with the door open that the cannon will come out of. So you can take a look at that. That's real nice. That's going to work out real well. On the back side, you can see the burn marks from the laser. You are going to have to take a scribe, and you're going to have to scribe lines on the front, and you just match them up to the same measurements on this side so that when you stain the wood and paint it, that you're going to have the same type of plank wood on the inside. Next up is just a sheet of plywood cut out by a laser with the nice dark edges, and that's going to be the floor of the ship. And that's going to be this part right here that the cannon actually sits on. And they do have planks, and we're going to have to plank that piece of plywood down. We're also going to have to take a saw or a small table saw and bevel the edge. Excuse me. Bevel the edge because the walls don't sit perfectly straight on a ship. They kind of arc in to follow the contour of the hull. So that's the deck plywood. Now this bag here, and we'll open it up. These, of course, are taped shut, and I had to open it up to count everything out. These right here are going to be your deck planks. And you can see they're, you know, 1/16 of an inch thick. There's 21 of them there. And you're going to be cutting these to all different sizes and placing them on the deck here so that you can get that perfect deck look. And then for the nails on there, you'll just use a very fine point dark marker like a brown or a gold brass mix to make it look like the deck's been planked down. You'll just use standard wood glue or white glue. I recommend a good quality wood glue. Why not spend a little bit of money on better glue so you know it's not going to warp later? And we've got some small parts of basswood. Most of all this is going to be basswood. You can see the larger parts, the 3/8 inch, the 1/4 inch basswood, the 1/8 inch by 12, and this wooden dowel, which is going to be used to make your tools. All of those parts are going to be your top rails, your side rails, your bulwarks, and the handles for your tools. And the heads of the tools are provided in cast metal, which we'll look at in a moment. So let's get that out of the way. Inside this nice little plastic box that they give you is all of your metal and specific parts for the kit. Now right away you see this beautiful, I think it's brass, cannon. I'm not exactly sure on the exact metals they use in these. I know they use a lot of pot metal and cast metal. And I think they do use some turned brass. This could be turned brass. This could be turned aluminum. But based on the color, I think it's a brass alloy. Very beautiful. And look at the size of that. And, you know, you can't feel it through the camera. But this has got a good weight to it. I wouldn't be surprised if this weighed 8 ounces. And you can see that that's going to end up being about 4 1/2 inches long. So it's a really nice size. And that's what makes me think it's 1/16 scale. Because I don't see 1/24 scale. I don't see 1/24 scale guys working on a cannon that size. It just wouldn't line up right. Some of the other white metal parts in the kit. You see that tiny little bucket. That's pretty awesome inside there. And you see some hinge straps. We've all seen doors like that before. And those are going to go on that door that swings out of the side of the ship for the cannon. And you can see here this tiny little part right there is the shovel, and that's for loading things in like gunpowder into the cannon barrel and filling it up. Of course, they're going to include different lengths and different types of string, or as they would be in real life, rope, for the different type of rigging you need to do. And you can see some wire that will also look like string and rope right there, and some copper wire for the same thing. Let's take a look at what else they got in there for rope. That's that, a little bit longer length. You can see it right there. And all of that stuff is going to be used because they use so many ropes on the ship. You can see it's going to be all this type of rigging through these pulleys and all these types of stay ropes and rigging ropes to pull it back and to launch it forward and to keep it from flying across the ship. That's what this giant rope would do when the cannon went off and it flew backwards. This giant rope would keep it from flying back and killing the guys behind it that were on cannons on the other side. So you can see somehow all this is going to go together. Now there's a huge amount of cast metal parts in here. I think they call this pot metal or white metal. I'm not a metallurgist, but you know, take my word for it. You can see all these different parts are going to come together, axles and braces for the back of the cannon to make them sit up straight. You're going to paint a lot of this to look like wood, but they make it out of metal so that the kit has a robust feel to it. And it's easier than having them laser cut out some parts. These are going to be the cannon stays on either side. This is going to be your big sponge that they use to daub off the barrel. And you're going to get a good chance at painting and staining, and spray painting and airbrushing to make all this look like wood, because that's what they used for the parts. These are cast metal, but in real life they weren't sitting on giant metal blocks, they're sitting on wood blocks. But the cast metal allows them to get much finer detail, and I prefer it. Cast metal doesn't have a lot of seams, and when it does, it's easy to fix and cover up with primer. It's just like working with a car body. A lot of the other parts in here are diminutive, very small parts. You can see these are double-sided pulleys, some small hangers, these little white metal hangers. Those are actually going to go on the kit right here and here, and that's where they hang their tools for loading and cleaning the cannon. They're just going to be sitting right there. So you can kind of see on the picture how it's all going to come together. There's some more rope, some eyelets, and these are real long. What you do is you drill a small hole and you insert the eyelet at the right depth, and then you measure that, you cut it off and glue it into place so you don't use the entire length. But they give you the entire length so that you can work with it. They include lots of brass rod and brass piping so that you can get all your details down perfect. They include this beautiful copper chain. You can see that there. That's about 6 inches of chain there. And the copper chain is used for when they would pull the ropes and yank the doors up. You can see the pulleys there. They would yank the doors up so that they could put the cannon, move it out, and start firing. This bag of a whole bunch of pins, those are actually your nails. And those are going to go on the side of the hull of the ship on the outside. And you'll have to drill each pilot hole real small and then poke the pin in, cut it off at the right length so that all these heads will end up looking like nails in the side of the ship. Some smaller eyelets, again, to use to hold the ropes down, to put everything together. Some split rings. Some single hold pulleys here. You can take a look at how nice and cool those look. And of course, some more split rings to round up all the parts. And that's it. That's everything that's included in one of these kits. And they're, you know, this is the first time I bought from Model Expo. This is the first time I bought anything from Model Shipways, which is available only from Model Expo, as far as I can find out. And I've built a good number of ship kits, and I really like this one. I think it was definitely worth the price I paid with shipping of $32. It was normally $40, and you would have paid another, you know, $9 in shipping. I don't really know if it's worth $50 because of the limited subject, but for everything I did get in the box, and as fast as they got it to me, they're based out of Florida, I definitely think it was worth the price of admission. Excuse me today. I want you to hold on here, and I'm going to come back, and I'm going to show you some of the tools that us model shipbuilders use when working on this equipment. So stick with me, and I'll be right back. Okay, we're back, and I've got some of the tools assembled that you're going to use when you get into building wooden model ships. Now, what I'm going to show you is what I have ended up amassing over all the years of building these ships. And I've been building these ships since I was a teenager. So we're talking over 20 years. You do not need all of this stuff to build wooden model ships. All you really need is a good razor saw, a good X-Acto knife, some pliers, an excellent ruler, some files, you know, and some hand drills. But I figured I'd just show you guys a lot of the tools I use since I like to build ships all the time, and it makes life a lot easier if you have some power tools to go along with what you're working with. So let's take a look at what I'm going to use to assemble this kit and what I've used to assemble numerous other wooden model ships. So first off, you see some tools that you've all recognized from other workshops, but these are just smaller. And this right here is a 3.5 to 4 inch, depending on what size blade you put in it, table saw. And I picked this up at Harbor Freight. And it is an absolute excellent saw. It's a direct drive saw. You can see the motors right on the blade. So it works just like a full-size table saw. You've got your miter gauge there. You've got your slots. It doesn't have a fence, but you would just clamp on your own out of a straight piece of metal that you have, like angle iron, or a piece of wood to run your straight edge. The bed is able to be raised and lowered and tilted, depending on how you want to tighten that up. And then, of course, it has your standard blade guard with a little bit of larger shield. And right now, I have a wood blade in it because I'm mostly cutting wood with it. But I do have a metal blade that I put in there every now and then to cut off some brass pieces or brass rod if I'm doing a whole bunch of it. I don't know if Harbor Freight has this for sale anymore. I bought this for under $50, and it's been invaluable in modeling because of the fact that I don't have to get out the big table saw and try to use that. Cutting a piece like this on a table saw, like this size, is very easy. Taking a piece of wood like this and cutting it on your 10-inch table saw can be done, but it's just, you know, it's not worth the hassle for me. So I picked one of these up quite a while ago, and you can see it's got a lot of use on it, and it works absolutely great. It's never underpowered. It just works wonderful. So if you can find these available for under $50, grab one. And it might come out handy in other types of modeling, too, for cutting any type of styrene or any, like, car bodies, cutting them into a convertible or anything like that. Next tool I want to show you is one that's used even more than the table saw, and this is the miniature chop saw. And this was also a Harbor Freight tool because so many other companies offer these tools, and they charge you $70 or $80 for it. Harbor Freight makes the exact same tool. And when I say not exact doesn't mean it's similar. I mean, this is the exact same tool that you will pay currently close to $100 for at Micromark, and I think that's absurd. I got this for about $30 at Harbor Freight, and I'm pretty sure they still sell it. It's got a nice cutoff blade right there, and these are about $10 for three of them. So you never, and I've never even gone through this one. And that's the one it came with, and it came with two more in the box. But when you're just cutting metal, real soft metal like brass or aluminum angle iron, and you're cutting just general basswood, balsa woods, light pine, light plywood, you're not going to, you know, you're probably never going to go through a blade on it. But it works great. It locks in the up position. Push the button, gives you your chop. You've got this beautiful clamp, which makes sure that you're holding the part in tightly. And then it's got the nice miter on there that you can adjust. So all the features of a big chop saw, all the features of your big, you know, miter saw, just in a much smaller package, much more handy for the modeler. One of the best tools for any modeler and anybody, no matter what they model, should have the Dremel Moto tool. Now, I've had this one for 25 years. I do have others. This one's my favorite because it is the oldest, and since you can replace the brushes on them, you know, there's no reason that one of these would ever wear out unless the magnets gave out on the motor, and I haven't had that happen. So this thing's been around for a long time. It's gotten pretty beat up, but they're excellent tools. Everyone knows what a Dremel is. Everyone should have one, whether it's a Dremel name brand, which is what I recommend because they last so long, or an off brand. Get yourself a rotary tool. It's going to save your butt a lot when you're doing modeling. Another tool you have to have when you're modeling model ships or any other model is your standard X-Acto knife. I don't need any with a fancy handle. I like just the cheap $1.50 metal handle, and keep replacing the blades. A fresh blade is what gets you through your kits. These right here, from the dollar store, a whole stack of emery sticks. We know what those are for. If you're working with a wood ship or a plastic ship, you're going to use a lot of these, and you don't have to try to clean them off when they get clogged. You just throw them away because there's, you know, 2-3 dozen of them in a kit for a dollar. Another fun tool, if you don't like using all the sanding things and you like to spend money, is this behemoth right here. And let's adjust the camera on that. That is a... what is that? You know what that is? That's a belt and disc sander. And this is also available at Harbor Freight. And you can see it's got the disc on the side, right there, with this handy slot and miter gauge, so you can make sure you sand everything off real flush. And then the main table can be adjusted by moving your lever here, and you've got that nice big belt to work with. So that makes sanding jobs a lot easier. You know, starting off sanding things, you can use a tool like this to get them to their rough shape, and then you can fine shape them with the emery boards and a moto tool. Those are a lot of the tools I use. We'll take a look at the workbench here real quick. And you can see all these tools behind here are used for all the different kind of modeling I do. And there's other stuff stashed away and in the drawers. But these are all the kind of things you're going to be using when you're doing different kinds of models, as far as I do, like radio control and wooden chip models, styrene models, resin models, all that kind of fun stuff. So I'm glad you stuck with me through this. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed looking at some of the tools. And when I start building this kit, I don't put a lot of builds on here, but I promise you guys that I'll try to do more builds instead of just showing off stuff. But when I start building this kit, which should be sometime this winter, hopefully, I will start doing segmented videos showing how it all goes together. Once again, I hope you enjoyed watching this episode of HPI Guys Model Workshop. And hopefully you'll enjoy my other videos. Thanks for watching.